This is what the Lord asks of you, only this, that you act justly, that you walk tenderly, that you walk humbly with your God. My children, I am with you such a little while, and where I go now, you cannot come. A new commandment I give to you, as I have loved you, so love each other. This is what the Lord asks of you, only this, that you act justly, that you love tenderly, that you walk humbly with your Lord. Do not let your hearts be troubled. Trust in God now and trust in me. I go to prepare a place for you, and I shall come again to take you home. This is what the Lord asks of you, only this, that you act justly, that you love tenderly, that you walk humbly with your God. Peace is the gift I leave with you, a peace the world can never give. If you keep my word, my Father will love you, and we will come to you to make our home. This is what the Lord asks of you, only this, that you act justly, that you love tenderly, that you walk humbly with your God. Hello. Come on. The name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. The Lord be with you. Today in the Gospel, Jesus tells all of us that we must become like children. What does he mean? We become like children because they trust in their Father. So we also must trust in God our Father. We ask God again to help all of us to become more and more like children of God. Lord Jesus, you were sent to heal the contrite of heart. Lord, have mercy. You came to call sinners. Christ, have mercy. You are seated at the right hand of the Father to intercede for us. Lord, have mercy. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Amen. Glory be to God the Father. Glory be to God the Son. Glory be to God the Spirit. Each is God, yet God is one. Let us pray. O God, your sacred law is founded on love of you and love of our neighbor. Help us to follow your law so that we may attain eternal life through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever. Amen.
A reading from the Scroll of Wisdom. People that do not believe in God say to themselves, good people are a nuisance. They are against us because of our way of life. They accuse us of breaking the law and not following the traditions of our people long ago. But we will see if what they say is true. We will see what will happen when they die. If these people are truly good, then God will save them from their enemies. So let us test them with cruelty and torture. We will find out if they are calm, gentle, and endure suffering. We will condemn them to a shameful death because they said God will protect us. This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. Response: the Lord gives me life. Response: the Lord gives me life. O God, by your name, save me. By your power, protect me. O God, hear my prayer. Proud people have no respect for God. Response: the Lord gives me life. But I know God will help me. The Lord gives me life. I will be happy to make sacrifices to you. I will praise your name because you are good. Response: the Lord gives me life. A reading from the letter of St. James. If there is jealousy and selfishness, there is confusion and evil. But the wisdom that comes from heaven is pure. Wisdom from God is also peaceful, kind, and friendly. Wisdom is full of compassion and shows itself by doing good. In wisdom, there is no hypocrisy. When peacemakers try to spread peace, they always sow seeds that will help people become holy. Why do you fight and quarrel with each other? How do fights and quarrels start? The fighting and quarreling comes from inside yourselves, from your selfish desires. You want things, but you cannot have them. So you are ready to kill. You strongly want something, but you don't have it. So you start to quarrel and fight to get your way. If you want something and you don't have it, it's because you have not prayed for it. When you do pray and don't get it, it is because you have not prayed properly. You have prayed and asked for things to use for your own pleasure. This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. Alleluia, alleluia. The Lord says, I am the light of the world. Any person that follows me will have the light of life. Alleluia.
The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Mark. Leaving the mountain, Jesus and his disciples, they went through Galilee. Jesus did not want anyone to know where he was because he was teaching his disciples. Jesus taught them, the Son of Man, he will be arrested. They will kill him, and 3 days later, he will rise again to life. But his disciples, they could not understand, and they were afraid to ask him. They arrived in Capernaum, and when Jesus was in the house, he asked them, what were you arguing about on the road? They said nothing, because they had been arguing which of them was the greatest. So Jesus sat down and he told the 12 apostles to come. And he said to them, if any person wants to be the first, the most important, that person must become the last of all and the servant of all people. Jesus showed his disciples a child, and he said to them, if any person welcomes this child in my name, they also welcome me. And if a person welcomes me, that person also welcomes the Father who sent me. The Gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. Sometimes when you see the things that are written in scriptures, they look a little bit stupid. Today, in our first reading from the Book of Wisdom, the people say that we sinners, we don't like this person because he is truthful and just. Let us see what we can do to him. They are sitting together quietly, making plans to kill this person. Who talks like that? It sounds stupid. The Book of Wisdom was written about 600 years before Jesus. But at the same time when Jesus is here on the earth, you can see the same words, the same words, same talk of people huddled together. But this time they're talking about him, Jesus. We don't like the things that he says. We must get rid of him, kill him. So in the Book of Wisdom, 600 years ago, the talk sounds silly. Who really talks like that? Well, the scribes and the Pharisees, they talk like that in the same way about Jesus. And they do kill him. And you can see the cross in any Catholic Church up here. We see in a different place in the Bible, Jesus tells his friends, I did not come to be served. I came to serve other people. And Jesus, he serves all of us so much that he goes to his cross here to save all of us from our sins. God sent Jesus to serve. So I think in the Gospel today, Jesus is telling all of us to serve each other, to serve our neighbours. Jesus takes a child and he says to his apostles, you must become like this child. So why does Jesus use a child as an example? That's because children depend. What's the sign for depend? Children depend on their parents. We must depend on God Himself. There is no other way. Jesus says in another place in the Gospel, I am the truth, the way, the life. You can only go to God through me. Jesus, He's giving all of us an example of how we must live. Children today, they love to receive gifts. Give, take, take, all the time. But when they grow up, that changes. So that when they become adults, most people love to give gifts. Not to receive them. But there is something special about giving to another person. Makes me feel happy. Makes me feel good that I've given something to that person. We must become like servants who give, not receive. We look at Jesus again. I came not to serve, not to be served, but to serve. And Jesus is the best example that we have. So today, maybe we need to pray for ourselves. There are some people, grown-ups, who they still love to take gifts. They love to receive all the time. But that's a bit sad. Because they will never know the wonderful feeling about giving. Giving is very special. Because when you give to a person, it shows that person that you love them. You think about them. I have chosen this gift especially for you. Jesus is the same. He shows all of us that He loves us so much, He goes to the cross to save all of us from our sins. So maybe today we should look again inside ourselves and ask, what person am I like? Am I a giver or a receiver? Which one? If you want to be the same as Jesus, it's more likely that you have to be a giver and not a receiver. It's okay to receive a gift, but I think it's much more special to be able to give, because it shows that person that you love them. And Jesus loves all of us. I believe in God the Father Almighty, Creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, His only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended into hell. On the third day He rose from the dead. He ascended into heaven, and is seated at the right hand of God the Father Almighty. He will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of the saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting. Amen. So now, again, we turn to God, asking Him to listen to our prayers that we offer in the name of Jesus.
We pray for all Christians that they may learn to be servants first. This is our prayer.
We pray to the Lord.
We pray for peacemakers throughout the world. We pray that we will all try to listen to each other carefully and ensure that all are justly treated and respected. This is our prayer.
We pray to the Lord.
We pray for children, especially those who are vulnerable and those who need love. This is our prayer.
We pray to the Lord.
We pray for all who are not well. Roy, Mary Jones' brother. Rachel, and those in hospitals and care homes. We pray to the Lord. We pray for those who have died. May the Lord give them love and mercy, and grant them the happiness of the kingdom. This is our prayer.
We pray to the Lord.
We ask Mary to join her prayers with ours.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Almighty and ever-loving Father, with courage we offer you all of our prayers through Christ our Lord. Amen. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, through your goodness, we have received the bread we offer to you, fruit of the earth and work of human hands. It will become for us the bread of life. Blessed be God forever. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation. Through your goodness, we have received the wine we offer you, a fruit of the vine and work of human hands. It will become our spiritual drink. Blessed be God forever. Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God the Almighty Father. May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church. O Lord, look with favour on our prayers and in your kindness, accept these your servants' offerings. Let our offerings help us to honour your holy name and to spread the salvation to all people. Through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you. Lift up your heart. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks. Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. His death we celebrate in love. His resurrection we confess with a living faith. And his coming in glory we await with eternal hope. So now with all the angels and the saints, we praise you and always acclaim, Holy, holy, holy Lord God of hosts. Heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and the blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time that he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving you thanks, he broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In the same way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more, giving you thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again. So therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer to you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and to minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and the blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, with John, our Bishop, and with all of the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, and Blessed Joseph, her husband, with the blessed apostles and all of the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, that we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Amen. So now, at the Saviour's command and formed through his holy teaching, we pray together. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Saviour Jesus Christ. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," to look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church. And graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. Amen. The peace of the Lord be with you always. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace. Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof. Only say the word and my soul shall be healed. Make me a channel of your peace. Where there is hatred, let me bring your love. Where there is injury, your pardon, Lord. And where there's doubt, true faith in you. Make me a channel of your peace. Where there's despair in life, let me bring hope. Where there is darkness, only light. And where there's sadness, ever joy. O Master, grant that I may never see so much to be consoled as to console, to be understood as to understand, to be loved as to love with all my soul. Make me a channel of your peace. It is in pardoning that we are pardoned, in giving to all that we receive, and in dying that we're born to eternal life. Just one announcement. This coming Tuesday, Mass in Sign Language here at 11 o'clock. Please, if you could come to join us, happy if you like. Okay. The Lord be with you. May Almighty God bless us, the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit. The Mass has ended. Go now to love and to serve the Lord. Oh yes, sorry. After Mass today, there will be confessions, but it will be here. So anyone who would like to go to confession, please maybe if you would queue up just here. Okay. I shall see you later.